When we arrived on Kashyyyk, things were just as bad as we feared. The droids had us outgunned, outmaneuvered, and outmanned by a 5-to-1 margin. What none of us had counted on was the Wookiees. We'd all heard the stories, of course, but we'd never fought next to them. Never seen them rip apart a droid with their bare hands. They were magnificent. Even so, it was still a suicide mission. At least it was until Master Yoda arrived. Then it became a battle. A winnable battle.
This is it, men. We have to hold this beachhead until reinforcements arrive. No retreats, no excuses. We must protect the Wookiee base. Refinery at all costs. If we don't, this whole place is going to blow.
Knock him down! Sniper! Sniper!
sea wall. Brace yourselves.
Hold them back, man. Now let's push forward and send them packing.
Proud I am to stand by Wookiees in their hour of need.
Thank you.
lives to fight another day.
Our second wave of troops is being depleted.
With the timely arrival of Master Yoda, the 501st was able to hold the line against the Seps on Kashyyyk. We left as heroes. Years later, we'd return as conquerors. In our bones, we knew the war was almost over. The galaxy held its breath, waiting to see which side would make the final daring move. As fortune would have it, the Republic moved first. After the Chancellor informed the Jedi Council that General Grievous and the Sept leaders were hiding on Utapau, General Kenobi gathered an army large enough to capture three star systems. When the orders reached the 501st, our morale soared. For better or worse, this would be the beginning of the end.
There is a two-story building just a bit southwest of your position. Assault that command post.
Take out that sniper! Rowan, heck, it's a stopper!
Capture the CP. Will serve as an excellent lookout point for our mission.
Great shooting, trooper!
CP further down the highway. Clear any enemies on the highway and secure the area. Send in a dropship to back you up. General Obi-Wan has landed on this level. He should be able to help you troopers quite a bit.
Friendly fire!
Although I'm leaving, the Force will be with you. Always.
Thank you.
Grievous is stationed in Hangar 10. Take him out before he wipes out our forces. Destroy those guns, then they're gonna land the heavy support units. The other gun at Hangar 10 will be ours. Reinforcements are nearly depleted. Stand by for heavy support unit, soldier. Tanks are incoming. Now, soldier, destroy that energy tower. for the Republic. We are victorious.
With the death of General Grievous at the hands of General Kenobi, the Utapau raid had broken the back of the Separatists. Under normal circumstances, it would have been a time for celebration. But our next orders put paid to those thoughts. What I remember about the rise of the Empire is how quiet it was. During the waning hours of the Clone Wars, the 501st Legion was discreetly transferred back to Coruscant. It was a silent trip. We all knew what was about to happen, what we're about to do. Did we have any doubts? Any private, traitorous thoughts? Perhaps, but no one said a word. Not on the flight to Coruscant, not when Order 66 came down. And not when we marched into the Jedi Temple. Not a word.
Tonight, the fall of the Jedi is at hand. We have been directed by the highest authority to wipe out the insurgent Jedi Order that threatens our great empire. Our first objective is to capture the Council Chamber. Lord Vader will be our field commander. Let's keep the Jedi low and move out.
For the Republic!
Gunfighter simulation!
Save it for the enemy!
Watch your fire!
Destroy that turret! Take down the Jedi!
Troops, double time to the library. The Jedi are attempting to destroy the library's holo box. In direct defiance of command, stop them. Stop the destruction of the Jedi holo box. If you can keep at least one of the bookcases intact for at least 2 minutes, command can scan the contents of the library. Tonight, the fall of the Jedi is at hand. We have been directed by the highest authority to wipe out the insurgent Jedi Order that threatens our great empire. Our first objective is to capture the Council Chamber. Lord Vader will be our field commander. Let's keep the Jedi low and move out.
One shot, one kill. Watch out for those lightsabers. Check your fire! On your side! Grenade! Grenade! They're coming around! Mark that turret!
Troops, double time to the library. The Jedi are attempting to destroy the library's holo box. In direct defiance of command. Stop them. Stop the destruction of the Jedi holo box. If you can keep at least one of the bookcases intact for at least 2 minutes, command can scan the contents of the library. Your next objectives are a pair of holocrons, rumored to contain the sum of Sith and Jedi knowledge. The first one is located on the comm room. Retrieve it and bring it to the veranda.
One shot, one kill. Don't let the Jedi get too close. Set them up and knock them down.
Thank you. near the Star Chamber. You must defeat this Jedi and bring his holocron to the veranda drop-off point. Of the holocron secured, we can deal with the remainder of the Jedi here. Execute the three Jedi Masters who have poisoned the minds of their impressionable students against the Empire. Let them bear witness to the cost of rebellion. Mission objectives complete. The Jedi Temple has been secured.
With the fall of Coruscant and the elimination of the traitorous Jedi, Palpatine's rise to power was complete. In recognition of our service and loyalty to the Emperor, the 501st were placed under the direct command of Lord Vader. Armed with deadly new weapons, blazing new ships, and shiny new armor, our presence let the galaxy know that the days of the Old Republic were well and truly over. We were establishing a new era, an era of order and peace.